Hey there. On this Build It Better episode, we're going to talk about when you need to suspend heavy loads and your acoustical ceiling can't support it. What do you do? Whether it's lighting and electrical equipment in a broadcast studio, like we're in right here, or devices and cameras in a warehouse or retail store, or maybe you need to suspend heavy signage or wood and metal architectural ceiling elements. Up until now, you had to design a structural stud or strut framework up in the plenum, then hang a ceiling down below it. How much vertical plenum space does that take? Plus, how congested and expensive does your plenum get? I'm going to show you a few projects where structural grid was used. Everything can now hang from a simple, all-in-one, single ceiling system. Now, what about the structural attributes of this grid? What you have up above you, the Dynamax extruded aluminum system, this will take 900-pound point loads with 3/8-inch threaded rod drops on 4x4 centers. That is beefy. This will hold a ton of weight. And the owner and the architect specified Dynamax in this broadcast studio because you can see they have electrical raceways attached to it. They have all different types of lighting and devices and pipes and things like that that they're going to attach things to when they're filming video in this broadcast studio. So for them, it was a win-win because they bring the ceiling system down to one plane. They can put lighting in it. They can put ceiling panels in it that fit right out of the box with this Dynamax system. The thing that's really nice with our structural grid system, be it the steel systems or the aluminum systems like Dynamax, is you can put strength where you need it. With grid on one level ceiling plane, right here we need strength because it's a broadcast studio. But what if 10 feet over we didn't need strength? Well, with that, this has axiom bosses along the height of the web of the grid, and we can take AXTBC clips, axiom T-bar connector clips, attach them to the axiom bosses, and then just run regular grid right off of this, right off the Dynamax. So you put strength where you need it in the ceiling plane by putting Dynamax here, and again, away down the room in a different area of the room, you could just attach standard grid into it really easily. Now, when it comes to lighting, right here they have can fixtures cut into the ceiling panels, but if you want lay-in lighting or linear lighting, with our partners, we have a lot of different options for you. From Axis, we have their tray fit lights that fit 2x2 or 2x4 right down in to a 2x4 or 2x2 opening. We also have linear lights that integrate with the groove on Dynamax, and our linear lights, we have two different options from Vode and JLC Tech. Now, with our steel system, Prelude Max, it can hold up to 300-pound point loads, but that's anywhere in between from like 93 pounds all the way up to 300 pounds, depending on if you're going to hang it by threaded rod or 9-gauge wire or 12-gauge wire. So you have a lot of options. So meet and work with our installation specialists out there to make sure you're getting the right system and the engineering you need to support what you need on whatever job you're working on.
So we're here with Kevin Larson from Olympic Companies, and a pretty unique install here where we started out with these GFRG plaster form canoes. And I think the challenge was finding a way to hang and align these things. And
Yeah, this is one of those projects. Yeah, you look at this when you're bidding a project like this, and so at bid time, I know it's going to be some challenges. We didn't quite have it figured out yet, but I knew with some help of some good partners like Armstrong, we'd figure it out, you know. So one of our biggest challenges here was the amount of mechanical above the space. This is a hospital still, so there's a lot of mechanical ductwork, pipes, cable trays, and all kinds of things. So initially, the way this project was kind of on paper was a strut system to try to support all these canoes. And my first thought of that is, as you can see, they all need to line up point to point, every direction. So I needed to have a way to be able to adjust these and get them into the right alignment. So just having a pure strut system, that would have been difficult to do. Not only that, but we wouldn't have had room even to, we were in such limited space because we had a a whole level of ductwork and pipes. We had a little space in between, and then we had a height that was required to get these canoe-shaped clouds in. So when we were doing that, I had to have a way to adjust this. So talking with John and just working through some of the process here of trying to figure out the right system, we came up with this Prelude Max system and dropping some threaded rod that would be supporting these canoes, but also I would have some flexibility to be able to move these things around once I get them in place and get them all aligned. So these really took some fine tuning, honestly, to look at these, because you're looking down a long run and these things all come to a point. So the points have to align every direction. So that was one of our biggest challenges. So to find a system like this that we could literally just put in place at one plane and be able to drop the system down in place and hold all these canoes up. It also had to be somewhat engineered to be able to support the weight of these. So had some help also with that, with the engineering department to help us get the weight figured out and to figure out how we're going to support these things. And yeah, one of those big challenges, we look at this, and as we're working our way through this big project, it's a million square foot hospital we're working on here. So this is one of our unique conditions that we had to come up with some solutions for, and knowing what was actually originally on the drawings even wasn't going to work. So we had to come up with a plan for this, and we did. This actually worked really well. These things came together nice. We were able to adjust them every direction, get them aligned. The architect was up here not long ago and just loved it. He just like, this is one of those things they draw on paper, not sure exactly how it's going to work either, but as contractors we figure it out and get it up in place, and it just worked really, really well. So
just looking up there, seeing how there's 5 hang points per piece, so each 20 hang points. Yeah, yeah, 20 hang points per canoe. So trying to hit all those hang points with strut, we were able to use a single layer system, Prelude Max, with a main beam, one custom T, and it was a directional T.
Yep.
So it would be able to hit all these hang points. And we can show the RCP that we came up with, but it was unique because every hang point was taken care of by the Prelude Max with one layout. So they could have a ceiling guy install this thing square, and that ensures their alignment. So it it's just a win-win.
So I'm coordinating all these pieces with Plasterform, our GFRG supplier, and how our hang points are going to be already kind of pre-installed into these canoe panels, shaped panels. And so once we get those in place, those are all done, and they're coming this way in a package. So I have to be able to make sure that my grid system aligned with all those hang points from a different manufacturer, tie all those things together and make sure everything works. But the coordination, we 3D modeled this, it just worked out really well. This is a huge success and a great thing to have this project, part of the project done. So
if you would like to learn more about Armstrong structural grid solutions, just go to the link in the screen below. Hang tough with Armstrong structural grid solutions. Everything can hang from a simple, all-in-one, single ceiling system.